When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it, darling, you look perfect tonight.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Anushka Sharma got married and her look was insane. She had a really, really simple kind of makeup look, but her outfit was banging and so was her jewelry. I've tried to recreate the look as close as I can. Obviously, she literally got married like yesterday and I'm filming this look the day after, so it was a bit difficult for me to get like exact pieces of jewelry and exact clothing, but this is as close as I could get. So I've got this beautiful jewelry and kind of floral detailing on the inside of this very gorgeous pastel colored dupatta and outfit from a designer called Aline's Creations. I will leave his details down below. Literally, he's kitted me out in all of this, which is fantastic. So yeah, I tried to recreate Anushka's beautiful bridal look as close as I possibly can, and it just goes to show, as an Indian bride, you don't have to do the full gold glam and all of that. You can just keep it really simple and neutral and then let your outfit and jewelry do all the talking, and it's just such a nice twist on the traditional Indian bride. So yeah, if you want to know how I got this look right here, then please keep on watching.
Okay guys, so I'm starting off with skin first, and I'm taking my MAC strobe cream in the shade Gold Light, and I'm just dotting this all over my face and also down my neck. We just want really healthy, glowy, moisturized skin. It's so important, especially for a bridal look, and because this has got a nice like gold tint to it, it's just it works really nicely with like a warm skin tone. And then I'm going to use another kind of glowy product, and this is the Backlight Priming Filter by Becca. This just is also going to enhance the glow in our skin, as well as keep our foundation and makeup on for a lot longer. And then I'm going in with my trusty Kevin Aucoin Central Skin Enhancer in the shade SX11, and I'm just taking this over any areas where I have any discoloration, any scarring, anything like that. As you can see, I'm just dotting over that, taking it down the sides of my nose, anywhere where I have redness. It's just going to cover it up nicely. And then for foundation, I've got my Hourglass Vanish Stick Foundation, and I think this is in the shade Golden Tan. Anyway, I'm just applying this all over my face, and then I'm going to stipple this foundation in with a brush. I actually prefer using a brush with this foundation rather than a beauty blender because I feel like I get maximum coverage out of it. But this foundation is going to give you beautiful, flawless looking skin. It's full coverage but not heavy on the skin, so it's perfect for this look. And then for concealer, I've got my NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer, which I took underneath my eyes, but my concealer was finishing, unfortunately. So I went in with my Maybelline Eraser Eye Concealer just to highlight areas around the face, all of the usual places, all of the high points, as you can see, that's what I'm doing. And then I have decided to cream contour as well, just because Anushka's look was really like beautiful and simple and natural, and I feel like cream contouring just gives you the best effects when you want like a natural kind of look. So yeah, I'm using this Smashbox contouring pen, and I'm just taking this through the hollows of my cheeks, temples, and down the sides of my nose. And then I'm using my beauty blender to blend in all of the concealer, like highlighted concealer parts first, and then I'm going to use another side of my beauty blender, and I'm just going to stipple over my contour areas just to buff it into the skin and yeah, blend it all out. And as you can see, stippling motion, not rubbing, and that way I'm keeping the product right where I want it. And then I'm just blending my NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer just over the eyes as well to prepare us for eye makeup later. Then to set all of these highlighted areas in place, I'm using my Vichy Derma Blend Translucent Powder. It's a really nice lightweight powder, and I'm applying it with a damp beauty blender sponge also. As you can see, I'm just patting this over the areas where I already highlighted, and by applying it with a sponge, it's just going to go on a lot lighter and not too heavy on the skin. And I'm going to allow it to sit on my face for basically the rest of the video until I'm ready to, because I just want to hold that makeup in place so I am baking. And then for brows, I'm using my Illamasqua eyebrow cake in the shade Thunder. It's basically a brow powder. I wanted a bit of a softer brow, not as harsh, so that's why I used powder. And then I'm going in with my Soap and Glory brow archery pencil just to get a bit of definition, and then just at the front of the brow, I'm just pushing up any excess product so that we have a soft kind of ombre brow. Then for the eyes, I'm using the shade Milk Chocolate from the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, and this is just going going on the outer corner and then through the crease. The eye look was so simple and easy. It's honestly, anyone can do this. I'm just building this up through the crease and buffing it out. And as you can see, I'm taking it in small circular motions to blend this shade a little bit higher because this is our transitional color. Then I am taking the shade Semi-Sweet from the same palette, so another warm brown tone, but a bit deeper than the first one. And then I'm just working this shade on the outer corner of the eye. And as you can see, through the crease also. I'm just going back and forth in windscreen wiper motions to blend this color out. And we just want a bit of deeper definition through the crease and not taking the shade up too high. And then I'm also taking the shade along the lower lash line for a bit of definition. And then I'm going to take the shade White Chocolate, which is a really nice bone colored vanilla colored matte eyeshadow from the palette, and I'm just patting this on the inner third of the lid. But as you can see, I'm not taking this up high into the crease or anything. And then just going back in with the brush that I used to blend the brown shadows with to kind of like blend the edges, so it's almost a bit like a spotlight eye kind of thing, like a light focus, but it's not defined whatsoever. Then I'm taking a black eyeshadow. This is the black eyeshadow from the Naked 2 palette by Urban Decay. You can use any. And just on an angle brush, I'm just working this along my lash line for a really nice soft smoky effect. And then I'm just going to create a winged liner with the black eyeshadow as well. And then I'm going to go over that with my Makeup Geek Kohl liner, just for a bit of definition, really nice and close to the lash line. And then go back over with your black eyeshadow, so just so that everything looks nice and soft. And then I'm taking that same pencil in my inner waterline on my top and bottom of the eye. So really nice deep definition in the eye, but nothing too crazy whatsoever. And then for mascara, I've got my L'Oreal Paradise Ecstatic Mascara. I really love this. I'm just applying a couple of coats of this onto my top and bottom lashes. And then for falsies, I'm going in with these Eylure Petit Fleur lashes. They're like three-quarter lashes that just go on the outer third of the eye. It's really just to give a bit of definition. They're like a really nice natural lash, and I feel like Anushka wasn't wearing any intense lashes, so these were perfect. And then I'm just going to dust away all of that bake that we've had sitting on the skin. And then for bronzer, I'm going in with my Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer, and I'm just taking a little bit of this, not too much, just on the areas where we already contoured. This is just to warm up the skin slightly, but I'm not going ham with the bronzer how I normally would. Again, it's just for a bit of warmth and definition. And then I'm going to use the same bronzer to contour my nose, just because it has a bit of an ashy tone to it, so it works perfectly. And then I'm going in with my Huda Beauty 3D highlighter palette, and I'm taking that bronzery shade just over where I've already like contoured and bronzed, just to add a bit of like glowy texture. It's not to add color or anything, it just adds glow, which I love. And then I'm using the highlighter from the same palette, which is beautiful, just on the top of the cheekbones and all of the other areas where I normally like to highlight. I felt like Anushka didn't have like a really intense highlight like how I normally would like it, but it was still on and it was still beautiful, and you gotta have highlighter on your wedding day, girl. So I just applied this all over the high points where I would normally like to highlight to add glow into the skin. And then for blusher, I'm using Peachy Keen by MAC, which is a really nice shimmery kind of blusher, again for extra glow. It's also a peachy color, so it gives a really beautiful flush to the cheeks. And then I'm just going back over that with like a brush that has like no extra product on it, just to buff it out. And then for the lips, I'm using the Rodial XXL lip liner, and this is in the shade Pink Espresso. So it's a really nice like your lips but better kind of shade, and I lined my lips with this and then colored them in with this lip liner. So this is like the main shade of the lips, because yeah, it just gave like a really nice pinky tone but not too much. And then for lipstick, I've used the Dose of Colors and Desi and Katie lipstick in the shade No Shade, so you can use any nude lipstick. And then I went over that with the lip liner again. But this is the finished look, guys. I really hope you like it. Please give it a big thumbs up if you do. Comment down below. Share this look. And thanks for watching. Mwah. Bye.